Welcome to the Weekly Examiner, where we examine this week's top stories. I'm Lisa Rule.
President Obama is on vacation this week in Martha's Vineyard, but that doesn't mean he hasn't been working. In between golf outings and family time, he took the time to address the ongoing situation in Iraq. Praising the efforts of the U.S. military's humanitarian mission in the embattled country, Obama said he couldn't be prouder of the men and women who carried out the mission flawlessly, speaking about the rescue of Yazidi refugees from atop Mount Sinjar. Obama also addressed the controversy in Ferguson, Missouri, coming from the police shooting of 18-year-old Michael Brown. Stemming from the shooting, there has been unrest in the Midwest town. Obama declared on Thursday there is never an excuse for violence against police, saying that this is a time for healing. As primary season continues to wind down, Connecticut, Minnesota, and Wisconsin held theirs this past Tuesday. In the Connecticut gubernatorial GOP primary, Tom Foley defeated his rival John McKinney. Foley will face incumbent Democratic Governor Danielle Malloy in the November elections, setting up a rematch of the 2010 election when Malloy defeated Foley by a slim margin. The Hawaii primary took place last Saturday, setting up an intense battle in the state's Democratic Senate primary. Congresswoman Colleen Hanabusa trails Senator Brian Schatz in a small margin of about 1,600 votes, with two precincts still yet to vote due to Tropical Storm Isel. In another stunning primary result, incumbent Governor Neil Abercrombie lost, becoming the first incumbent governor in Hawaii to lose the primary, and only the second to lose a re-election bid. Next week, keep your eyes on the campaign trail. Wyoming will be the only state holding their primary elections on Tuesday.
For up-to-the-minute breaking political news, be sure to stay with WashingtonExaminer.com throughout the weekend and check out the latest edition of Washington Examiner magazine on newsstands Monday. Enjoy your weekend, and we'll be back with you Monday for the newest edition of Morning Examiner.